intermolecular forces. Now, these are forces which hold solids, liquids, and gases together. Without these forces, we simply wouldn't exist, neither would life as we know it today. There are forces between molecules that keep the molecules together and are responsible for many properties, including, but not limited to, the melting point, boiling point, surface tension, etc. All of these depend on the strength of the intermolecular forces between the molecules. So, from this we can say that these are very important. The second force is Coloumbic forces. Before we go into this bond, let's talk about why these bonds form. We all know that like charges repel each other, and also opposite charges attract each other, for instance electrons and protons, as well as protons repel protons. An atom in which consists of both a positive proton and a negative electron, which would mean that if it came close to another atom, its proton would attract to the electron of the other atom and vice versa. This means a Coloumbic bond would be formed. Keep in mind, no actual physical bond is formed. It is merely an attraction of oppositely charged species. This is similar to how ionic bonds are formed, but instead of atoms, they have ions, and they are much stronger bonds. For example, sodium chloride, also known as table salt. Dipole-dipole attractions. First, we should note, in a molecule, one atom are usually more electronegative than the other atom. That atom pulls the electrons closer to itself, leading to unequal sharing of electrons between atoms. The side where the electron density is higher results in a partially negative charge, and the other side, which is partially positive charge. This is known as a dipole. This leads to our next intermolecular force, dipole-dipole attractions, which occur when two dipoles interact with each other through space. The partial negative portion of one dipole is attracted to the partial positive portion of the second dipole. Thus, a dipole-dipole is born. Ion-dipole attractions. This is a simple attraction between an ion and a dipole instead of a dipole and dipole. The ion can be positive or negative. In this case, the dipole has a partial negative charge and is attracted to the positive charge of the ion. An example of this, when the partial negative charge of a water molecule, which is polar, is attracted to the positive sodium ion, thus causing something like salt to dissolve in solution. Ion-dipole forces are much weaker than covalent or ionic bonds, but are one of the strongest intermolecular forces. The second last one is hydrogen bonding, and it's a special case of dipole-dipole attraction, in which each dipole contains a hydrogen and a strong electronegative atom, like fluorine, or for example nitrogen, and oxygen. This causes the hydrogen to have a permanent partial positive charge, whereas nitrogen, oxygen, or fluorine have a permanent partial negative charge. These permanent partial charges form attractive forces between each other. This type of bonding gives substances like water to have much stronger intermolecular bonds. This means that water has a much higher boiling and melting point than substances with similar molecular weight, as hydrogen bonding is present and is much stronger than most dipole-dipole attractions. The last force is London dispersion forces. To understand this, we need to remember that in a molecule, there are electrons constantly revolving around it, and there can be instances where most electrons are on one side, which would cause a partial negative charge as well as a partial positive charge to form. And this can happen to other molecules as well while this is happening, thus causing attraction between those other molecules with this molecule and forming a temporary bond. However, since electrons constantly move, so these charges are temporary, so the bond is broken quite quickly, making this force the weakest, and though it exists in all states, it is dominant in only gases. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a like. Thanks for watching. See you next time.